we welcome Simon Rattle.
Hello.
One of the most brilliant of the younger conductors of this generation.
Let's go for the jugular.
What are we looking for in a conductor?
An ability to physically put across sounds.
One of our most celebrated musical figures.
So deeply musical, and when you're this good, you can afford to be a bit of a daredevil.
One of my faults is that I can often love music to death.
I love Simon Rattle. I think he brings a real charisma.
They're starting with a real band.
What does a conductor do?
I was much too fast the other night.
He does everything that doesn't involve playing the notes.
Thank you.
Simon Rattle was born in Liverpool in 1955.
How did your music making begin?
There's always been music in my family.
At 19, he won an international conductor's competition.
Many nice old ladies had said to him, "Oh, Simon, you're wonderful." 16, 17, he knew he couldn't be.
He spent 3 years with the Bournemouth Symphony Orchestra, then the Liverpool Philharmonic and the BBC Scottish.
As a guest conductor, one is absolutely fated to conduct the same five pieces, most of which end loudly.
You're going to the City of Birmingham Symphony Orchestra?
Oh, yes. It was really the start of my proper music making.
It's enough to make him a spoilt and willful brat.
Conductors are the last autocrats left.
It hasn't.
The day of the autocrat is over.
At Birmingham, he's worked miracles.
Any violinist needs their Stradivarius to play on. I've always felt that I really need my own orchestra. And they know what my strange gyrations mean.
And the BBC came up with the rather alarming idea of filming our first day's work together. We were preparing Tippett's Concerto for Double String Orchestra.
Same level, just whisper.
The arrival of a charismatic young conductor with a passion for Mahler.
But Mahler's been with me all my life.
The performance that is on this television programme now was certainly my 40th.
Mahler's Seventh Symphony, and it's a piece that's been imprinted on Simon Rattle's musical soul for decades.
That it'll suddenly take off.
What is it about Ravel and these pieces in particular that you love?
It's the idea of storytelling, it's the idea particularly of childhood, although the Scheherazade is one of the most grown-up pieces.
What Ravel has achieved is an orchestra without feet that shimmers and hovers.
I'll be on the stage myself, surrounded by the orchestra, painting pictures which are choreographed to the music and projected onto a large screen.
One of my aims is to confuse people so that they think that Simon is actually painting the pictures with his baton.
In other words, he is creating the image from the music.
I would like to do more modern music than they have had,
yes,
and to try and get this thorny problem of trying to get contemporary music across to audiences.
The idea that came up of having a composer in residence in the form of Mark Anthony Turnage has been also an enormous boon.
Both of us are quite big football fans.
What is marvellous for us in Birmingham is that as we've experimented, the audience has come with us.
Simon Rattle is well known for championing new music.
What can we do now that's new, that no one's heard?
For a young composer in this country, or indeed anywhere, to get noticed.
Thank you.
A Child of Our Time, for me, it's one of the great pieces of not so much witnessing as universalizing conflict. The Bach Passions make great play of the chorales that were known at the time. In their place came spirituals. Just one of those great bits of inspiration. And maybe it was the first time in my life that I realized that music could make you cry. Art and music will always bear witness to the resurgence of the human spirit.
Thank you. That is so evident in all of his music, that these sounds, these combinations of sounds, these marvelous orchestral harmonies that he gives us.
It was really one of the most special collaborations I ever had.
I met Simon in 1976. This energy, but there's a calmness with it too.
Oh, I got plenty of nothing, and nothing's plenty for me. I got no car, I got no mule, I got no misery. The folks with plenty of plenty got a lock on the door. Fate somebody's going to rob them while he's out a making more. What for? I got no lock on the door, that's no way to be. They can steal a rug from the floor, that's okay with me, cause the things that are prized like the stars in the skies are all free. Oh, I got plenty of nothing, nothing's plenty for me. I got my gal, I got my song, got heaven the whole day long. No use complaining, got my gal, got my love, got my song. Nothing's plenty for me. I got the sun, I got the moon, got the deep blue sea. The folks with plenty of plenty gotta pray all the day. Seems with plenty you sure gotta worry how to keep the devil away. Away. I ain't a fret about hell till the time arrives. Never worry, long as I'm well. Never want to strive to be good, to be bad. What the hell, as bad as a life. Oh, I got plenty of nothing, and nothing's plenty for me. I got my gal, I got my song, got heaven the whole day long. No use complaining, got my gal.
I myself was a percussionist, and one of the great joys of making this program was to come face to face with a gamelan orchestra, not only to be able to hear them play and marvel at the fabulous skills of their executants, but also to attempt to play myself and to realize how very, very hard it would be for any Western musician to start in this world. This thing that's always in Tom and Jerry, that sound, it's like a frame for everything. But within it, they would use almost anything. I think sometimes just to keep the composers amused.
And the chord that always comes into my mind whenever I think of the Sinfonia is this chord that sounds again and again and again, and he uses them like a mantra. And there's the other chord in which the first movement is made up, of which has a fifth at the bottom, and then just all thirds.
Thank you, Mr. Simon Rattle.
The very beginning of the March to the Scaffold has, for the first time ever, a double bass is divided into four parts. It's like the sound of distant thudding. Also, the timpani rhythm is given staggeringly explicit instructions. She said one note of each six should be played with both sticks at the same time.
the other five to be played with the right hand. We have attempted to do this. Also, he writes for the horns in a very particular way. Although by this time valve horns were coming into prominence, he said the horn players should not use their valves. They should stop the notes by hand, making the particular fizz and slightly out of tune sound. Once again, we have attempted to do this. Normally the horn players just take the easy way out and stuff a mute in the bell.
Sir Simon Rattle has been chosen as the new chief conductor of the Berlin Philharmonic.
I felt like I had found a voice that I had never had and that I had always been searching for.
Simon has got great daring.
And he has this incredible sense of what's the best way to get a whole group of people to have an amazing moment of discovery together.
In a disused bus depot in East Berlin, where a couple of hundred disadvantaged youngsters were brought together with this orchestra.
It's a really extraordinary thing, and I'm so happy that we have the chance to do this. So let's play some music now.
Thank you.
if you think what was going on in the world and in Spain in 1939, it was after the Civil War, it was just as the Second World War was starting. And of course, it's the very essence of a type of Spain that he must have felt was being lost.
Thank you.
Feel his sense of enjoyment, control.
Our world divides into people who are supremely confident and those who have doubts every day. I'm on the doubts every day team.
The ceaselessly imaginative Simon Rattle.
He smiles often while he conducts because he loves the music.
Another life I could have imagined being an actor. And of course, in some ways, you are an actor.
I was also at the National Youth Orchestra when I was at school, which was my first really specialist training.
If you teach music, you do it. And even more important, you actually compose it. What is creativity, and can creativity make you live forever? And the answer is yes, it can. Then you are immortal.